Hey skaters, I'm Dirty Deborah Harry with the Dirty School of Skate and Sugar Up Roller Skates, and I'm here today in Long Beach, California to talk to you today about how to go uphill. Now, this is going to be a companion video to the next video about how to go downhill, which will be on my channel, the Dirty School of Skate. So, I'm guest coaching here on Planet Roller Skaters. So, hello, Planet Roller Skaters. I'm very happy to be here and have this opportunity to teach you all today. So, I'm gonna give you the very quick and dirty version about how to skate uphill. And it all starts with skating in a V pattern. When you skate in a V pattern, I'm saying that I need your heels to be almost touching when you start. Drop your hips down, have your arms out. Now I want you to take your center line of balance and push it over to one side. Push it over so this skate can roll. Push it over here so this skate can roll. But that's not all there is. There's so much more to it. When you're pushing over, or transferring your weight over to one foot, I need you on an outside edge. For those of you who do not know what an outside edge is, it's when we have our body weight primarily on one foot. We are down and our weight is transferred over to the outside of our skate. That means our knee is over our baby toe and pushing. You'll be able to feel your outside edge when you can feel pressure on the outside boot, when you can feel pressure on the outside wheels, and the lip or edge of your wheel feels like it's digging into the ground. So let's go over that part again. We're going to be in a V pattern, and we're going to push over to our outside edge, push over to our outside edge, lean over to our outside edge, drop our body weight over the top of our skate over to our outside edge. Now, you literally could do this all day long, but if you've got a big hill in front of you, you're gonna need more than just leaning. I'm going to need you to skate on your outside edge while simultaneously pushing off with the other foot on an inside edge. So we just talked about outside edges. Let's talk about inside edges. Inside edges when we have our body weight down primarily on one foot and our knee is pushed down and over our big toe. You will feel the pressure on the inside of your boot. You will feel the pressure on the inside wheels. The lip or the edge of your wheel, you will feel that digging into the ground when you are on a true inside edge. So we are skating on an outside edge, pushing away on an inside edge simultaneously to get up the hill. So it looks like this. Again, my heels are together. I'm gonna start off to the left. I drop my body weight down. I lean and push, lean and push, lean and push, lean and push, lean and push. So if you get confused at all about this, you just feel like I'm pointing my knee in the direction that I want to go, all right? So when we have our feet in the V position, I'm gonna point my knee this way, and you see this knee is pointed this way, all right? So we're gonna go to the left, to the right, to the left, to the right, to the left, and to the right. The power comes from the inside edge really digging in. Now, let's talk about the rest of the body, because when you're skating uphill, you cannot stand up nice and straight. That will cause you to lose momentum. We need you to lean forward. You're gonna have your chest area a little bit more over the top of your skate, okay? And then here's the other part. We're gonna keep our chin up, shoulders straight across, neck area tight as always, but let's talk about the movement of our arms. In most everything in skating, the movement of your arm is very important because oftentimes it will be static, where it'll just be helping you maintain balance, or it'll be moving in a way that mimics the movement of the bottom half of your body. So let's take a look when I skate in a V pattern, what happens with my upper body. I've got my V pattern here, my arms are out. I'm gonna skate left, right, left, right. know if you can see that, but my arms are kind of doing this nice swaying motion from side to side. So the body gets into a nice fluid rhythm. We are trying to go with the flow, even though we are trudging up this hill. The more that you can stay relaxed, the more that you can flow with it, the easier it is. Remember, we're on wheels, so we want to, even though we're going uphill, we want to have a sense of glide and ease as we're doing it, okay? I'm going to show you one more time. We're really going to focus on the upper body. Watch my arms. Got my feet in a V position, and I'm going to lean and push, lean, push, and glide, okay? Now, there is going to be a point, this happens to me every single time, I'm going up like a big hill, and there's a point where I'm gliding and leaning and looking and feeling good, and people are walking by, and I'm trying not to look like I'm actually dying, so I try to put on a nice smooth face, and I can smile and say hi. Meanwhile, I'm just completely dying. Well, that's where I need to change the way that I move uphill, and that's where toe stops come into play. Trust me, if you're not wearing toe stops outside, you're missing out. Toe stops are like a tool in the arsenal. Now, if you're dance skating outside, and I get that, you're on a very defined surface and you don't want to wear toe stops, fine. But if you are street skating, if you are skating hills, use toe stops. It's a good tool. Now, this is what happens. I'm going to do VVV, and then I'm going to start hitting my toe stops because this is exactly what I do when I start losing it, where I'm like, oh my God, I got nothing left. I'm going to really have to just bear down. I do this, I'll show you. So I put my feet in a V position, and I'm here, I'm trying to glide, and then I start struggling. I put one toe stop in the ground, I push off it, I go to the other toe stop, push off, push off, push off, push, push, push. When I do that, I am, instead of swaying side to side, I'm skating really linear. I am imagining myself in the tightest hallway possible, trying to get everything really close and channel all the energy, pressure, and force into these toe stops. So all I'm doing is taking my toes, pushing them over my front truck or my front axle to get the toe stop in the ground. The second that happens, I can push off it, comes up, push off, push off, push off, etc. Now, let's look at the upper body. My arms end up helping me, just like when we were swaying side to side, except I'm gonna keep the arms really tight and forceful in front and alongside my body. So I'm gonna push, 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 push. In previous videos, if you're familiar with my videos at all, there's little tricks you do to create energy and power in your arms. One of them is to extend your middle finger. Now, extend it down, not out and up, okay? You extend it down, it tightens up all the tendons in your arms and gets them really strong. So you'll see me and I end up like this, which my mom called the bird of paradise when I was a figure skater, okay? So I'm going up the hill and it's dun, dun, dun. There's a cop. Hi. We love the Long Beach PD. Here's me suffering, going up a hill. I'm like, God, should I quit? And then I'm like, no, I've got options. What? Let's go. Okay. So you saw the movement in my lower body was mimicking, or my movement, my upper body was mimicking what was going on down below, but we're counterbalancing so you don't feel like you get off balance. As the left foot goes forward, the right arm goes forward, I'm pushing off my toe stops, one arm in front of the other, one toe in front of the other. All right, skaters, so we've gone through our V pattern. The most important thing about the V pattern is understanding the difference between your outside edge and your inside edge, how to glide on your outside edge and how to push with power on your inside edge. So we're gliding with the out, pushing with the in. So it's glide out, push inside edge, glide out, push inside edge. If you can get those two, that difference between your inside and your outside edge down, hills won't be so troublesome going up. When you start to lose it, or you just feel like this gliding and whatnot is not as strong as I want it to be, then I want you to flip to your toe stops, shoulders straight across. I need your snack area tight, your arms down, lean, and I want you to draw those arms up, counterbalancing as you're pushing off your toe stop. With each push of your toe stop, I want you to extend your leg, okay? That means I push off, extend, extend. When you push off with your toe stop, and I tell you to extend your leg, realistically, what I'm saying is tighten up your ass cheeks, tighten up your legs, tighten up your calf, and point your toe. That is what ultimately is gonna get you the longest roll all the way up the hill. All right, skaters, so that's what I've got for you. I need you to practice those two methods of getting yourself up the hill. And then when you're done watching this video, I need you to pop over onto Dirty School of Skate, where I will show you the best, easiest, safest way to get yourself downhill. All right, skaters, as always, I'm gonna need you to practice, because without practice, we don't get. Have a wonderful day, and we'll see you over at my channel.